Hey guys, what's going on? Blaine back for another Netflix review, and today I'm going to be talking about Tell Me When. Tell Me When is a Mexican rom-com that starts off in the United States and takes its main character, Will, on a big journey across Mexico City. Will is a Mexican-American man who lives with his family in Los Angeles, and he doesn't really live all that exciting a life. He more or less just goes to work and then comes home and then doesn't really do much else outside of that. Even when his family throws him a surprise birthday party, he's not all that particularly thrilled about it, which prompts his grandfather to take him out in the middle of the desert for some reason, and he proceeds to try and reveal his birthday gift that he has for him, but it's not long after that happens that he eventually suffers a heart attack and dies. After the funeral, about a year or so passes into the movie, and Will is going through his grandfather's personal belongings, and he discovers a notebook among those belongings that details a list of wishes and desires that his grandfather wanted fulfilled before he passed away. This prompts Will to go on a personal journey to Mexico City as he tries to carry out his grandfather's last remaining wishes while also trying to spice up his own life and make it more interesting. So he's kind of getting rid of two birds with one stone. Will gets a place to stay while he's in Mexico City as he's paired up with this woman named Danielle and gets to crash at her place, and then from there the rest of the movie takes off, and you know exactly what the movie's going to focus on at that point. It's going to focus on both Will trying to carry out his grandfather's last remaining wishes while also trying to balance a romance with Danielle at the same time. I can't help but feel like this movie is trying to combine two cliche story ideas into one movie, which wouldn't be all that bad if the characters were a lot more memorable, but sadly, for the most part, that isn't the case in this movie. Will is just flat out bland as hell. He has no friends, he's never been in a relationship before, doesn't have anything in the way of hobbies, he's just your typical average boring introvert. And whenever something interesting does happen in the movie that relates to Will in some way, shape, or form, he just has a very muted reaction to everything that happens around him. He maintains the same tone of voice and facial expression throughout the movie. He just seemed unimpressed with everything that was happening around him. And I get that Will hasn't gotten all that much stimulation in life, and he hasn't had a lot of social interactions and all that. I completely understand that 100%, but it doesn't change the fact that he's just so boring to follow as a protagonist. Danielle, on the other hand, made things up for me a bit more compared to Will. She just seemed more outgoing and lively, she had a friend network that she connects with and she's close with, and on top of that, she actually has hobbies that she does in her spare time. She was 100 times more interesting than Will. Danielle's an aspiring actress who really wants the lead role of a play that's coming up, but she's relegated to the role of understudy as she gets to be stuck in the shadow of this bigger named actress named Ludwika that actually has the part, and there were just all kinds of more interesting things that were going on with the whole acting angle. I was 100% more interested in what was going on with Danielle than anything that had to do with Will. There's also this guy named Beto who's kind of the main comedy relief in this movie, at least I felt anyway. He's one of Danielle's best friends, and he's basically the bridge between Will and Danielle who helps set up their romance from the outset. I couldn't help but compare this movie to Bucket List when I was watching it. It just had the same sort of premise of main characters going on a journey trying to cross off things on a list, except compared to Bucket List, Tell Me When starts off by having the main character of this movie continue where someone else left off. But even though it's a little bit different in that sense, ultimately it's nothing that you haven't seen before, doubly so considering the fact that this is a romantic comedy, and we all know how typical the genre is at this point. I found that all the little plot beats in this movie that were used to develop the romance between Will and Danielle weren't really all that interesting. A lot of these things that happen in the movie go back to the list where Will and Danielle are touring all over Mexico City, and they just go to restaurants and museums, they look at paintings, and they do one or two other things here and there, but it's really nothing all that exciting. There are a few great moments in the story where Danielle gets to show off her bright and bubbly personality, and she's got some really funny dialogue written with her character, but because Will takes his blandness with him wherever he goes, neither the comedy or the romance land as well as they should. The romance just felt totally undercooked and one-sided to me. There was absolutely no chemistry between the two actors whatsoever in this movie. This all being said though, I'd be lying if I said that there weren't a few good parts in this movie here and there, and there were some scenes in this movie that were genuinely hilarious. There's a scene in the movie where the bigwig actress Ludwika ends up getting injured, and Danielle's asked to take over for her. The way that whole thing played out on camera was hilarious to me. Danielle's talking to the director on the phone, and he's relaying the news to her, and she's reacting all calmly and collectively, very professional, and as soon as she hangs up that phone, all hell breaks loose. Danielle goes to relay Beto the good news, and they both start screaming at the top of their lungs, are going, ah, ah, and then Will gets caught up in the celebration. He goes, ah, ah, I don't know what we're cheering about. That was one of the few moments in the movie where Will actually started to show some semblance of a personality, and I would have really loved to see more random moments like that. As I've said in previous videos, random bits of humor are my absolute favorite type of comedy. There's also a great scene in the movie that happens between Will and Danielle concerning the topic of the friend zone. I'm not going to spoil anything that relates to that particular scene in the movie in case you're interested in watching it, but it was by far the funniest part of the movie. It had me rolling with laughter. Just everything surrounding that scene was amazing, from the way that it was edited, to the cinematography and how it was all set up, to the soundtrack that they used in the background, which, by the way, that's another thing. This movie's soundtrack is phenomenal. Even though this is a Mexican movie, I noticed that there weren't really all that many Spanish language songs in the movie. A good chunk of this movie's soundtrack is completely in English, and I even recognize a song or two here and there. One of them being by Patsy Cline, and I really didn't expect Patsy Cline to be featured in a movie like this. The movie even surprised me here and there by showing a few scenes that combined computer-generated special effects with real-life practical effects. It was just a very technically well-made movie, and it's just a shame that it got hampered down by its narrative. Overall, Tell Me When isn't all that bad, but it's really not all that great either. It just sits squarely in the average zone, and it's not going anywhere. I apologize if anyone was looking into this review hoping that I have a more in-depth opinion on it, but I honestly don't have anything else to say about this movie. It's just completely forgettable for me. I just find it funny how this movie is about a character that's trying to make his life more interesting when the movie itself is anything but. If you're in the mood for an average romantic comedy, and I really emphasize the word average, I guess there wouldn't be any harm in watching it, but honestly, there are way better movies out there that you can watch than this. The two lead characters are complete polar opposites from each other, which is just bad for a romance movie. And even though there were some technical and comedic aspects that I did like in Tell Me When, it ultimately left me wanting a lot more than what I got. Anyways, guys, that's gonna wrap up my review of Tell Me When. Thanks for watching this video, I hope you enjoyed it, and as always, stay tuned for the next part, where next time I review Headspace's latest Netflix series, Guide to Sleep. Bye-bye!